بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وصلى الله وسلم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وبعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وبعد tonight the night of the 11 Right, tonight, the night of the 11th of what month? Rabia, we pass Rabia. You got two Jumada. You got very good, Jumada al-Ula. So tonight, the night of the 11th of the month of Jumada al-Ula, what year? 1439, after what? After the Hijrah. After the Hijrah. Ma ma'ana al-Hijrah fi al-Lugha. What is the meaning of Hijrah in the language? في اللغة في اللغة in the language الهجرة في اللغة الترك to abandon أما في الشرع it is الانتقال الشرك إلى لأجل الدين أحسنت so tonight بإذن الله The night of the 11th of Jumada al-Ula, 1439 after the Hijrah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We are continuing the reading of Sharh Nawaqid al-Islam 10 by our noble Sheikh Salih al-Fawzan from the matan of al-Mujaddid Muhammad ibn Imam Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab al-Tamimi rahimanallahu wa iyyah wa askanahu fi jannat al-Ula. So we were reading the first questions that was asked after the first nawaqid, which was Barakallahu fikum ash-shirk fi ibadatillahi ta'ala, ascribing partner with in aspects of worship for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the questions that was asked Barakallahu fikum, to briefly go back to the questions, number one was that some of the scholars that they mentioned in regard to the sins كلها داخلة تحت الشرك الأصغر. Some of the scholars they mentioned that all of the sins they are mentioned under that which is شرك الأصغر. فهل هذا القول صحيح? Is that statement true or not? And the Sheikh فأجاب he mentioned he said not every act of sin or act of a disobedience to Allah is shirk. He said منها ما هو الشرك وَمِنْهَا مَا هُوَ غَيْرِ الشِّرْكِ You have those that are acts of shirk, and you have those that are not acts of shirk. The second question, he mentioned, لَقَدْ ذَكَرْتُكُمْ أَنَّ الْعُلَمَاءَ That you have mentioned, O Shaykh, حَفِظَهُ اللَّهِ That some other scholars, may Allah have mercy upon them, اِخْتَلَفُوا فِي شِرْكِ الْأَصْغَرِ They have differed in regard to the shirk al-asghar, whether or not it will be forgiven if the person die with it without repentance. Right? Muhammad, you remember that mas'ala? Ahsant. So whether or not it will be forgiven if the person die on it or not. Because the umumul ayah, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَن يُشْرَكَ بِهِ Because this is عام. أَيِّ يَشْتَمِلْ الشِّرْكُ الْأَكْبَرُ وَالشِّرْكُ الْأَصْغَرُ So he mentioned that you have mentioned that the scholars, they have differed in regard whether or not their Shirkul Asghar, if a person die with it, that whether or not it will be forgiven or not. And the Shaykh Hafidhahu Allah, he mentioned what is Ar-Rajih Indahu. Wallahu A'lam, that it is in it. It enters in it. So you, this is why the person, Barakallahu Fikum, has to constantly seek, yani tawbah. Right? Tubu ila Allahi tawbatan nasuha. Yani repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Min jami'u dhunub. From all the sins, barakallahu fiq. And the question was in regard to at-tabarruk, seeking barakah. Mata yakunu shirkan wa mata la yakunu shirkan. When will it be shirk and when will it not be shirk? He mentioned, hafidhahullah, idha a'taqada anna al-tabarruk tahsulu min ghayrillah. If the person believes that the barakah will be given or will be granted by from other than Allah, He say مثلا بأن يتبرك بالأشجار أو الأحجار يعتقد. He say that by way of him seeking the barakah from the trees or from the rocks, meaning he believed that he will be granted the barakah by way of this. He say that this is shirk al-akbar والعياذ بالله. Believing that this cup will give me barakah, this is shirk. But أما إذا اعتقد, but if he believes in that this بسبب هذا, by way of this, that he will have the barakah, then this is barakallah fikum shirkul asghar. If he believe that, مثلا the person believe that this is giving him barakah, هذا يعتبر إيش شركل أكبر. But if he believe يعتقد بسبب هذا يحصل له البركة, if he believe that by way of this he will have barakah from Allah, then هذا بارك الله فيم إيش شركل أصغر. لا بد أن نميز بين هذا وهذا. We must make a difference between these two things. And this is the reason why the Khawarij, they went astray. Because they cannot make the difference between Shirkul Akbar and Shirkul Asghar. If you cannot make the difference between Shirkul Akbar and Asghar, if a person, Barakallah Fikum, do a minor shirk, that you're gonna tuhkam alayhi bi'ash, bi kufr. That you're gonna be ridda, you're gonna tell he is an apostate. And he was still under the fold of Islam. He was still under the fold of Islam. The other question was, if a person make a slaughter, inda qabri fulan, if a person come to the graveside of a person, a righteous person or whatnot, in his grave, and he slaughter in that grave, and he mentioned that, now what do we say? Is that action shirkul akbar or it is shirkul asghar? The Shaykh Hafidhahullah answered that question by saying, إِذَا كَانَ الذَّبْحَ لِلْمَيِّتِ, if the slaughtering is for the deceased one, meaning he is slaughtering بِفُلَان المَيِّت صَاحِبُ الْقَبْرِ, if he does that, then that action is shirkul akbar. If he slaughter that for the mayyit, for the deceased one in the grave, this is shirkul akbar. أَمَّا إِذَا كَانَ ذَبْحَهُ لِلَّهِ, as if is his slaughtering is for Allah alone. ولكن يظن, but he think that if he slaughter it in this makan, أن هذا المكان فيه الفضلية, if he slaughter in this place, that there is some virtue in this place, فهذا شرك الأصغر, that action is a act of minor shirk. طيب, you see the difference? Now here you got two people slaughtering in the grave. One can be doing minor shirk, and the other one can be falling in the major shirk. طيب. But we will say that both of them, they are evil. Because the one, even the one that is slaughtering, طيب, for Allah, but believing that, you know, this place is a very good place because it is the grave of so-and-so, if somebody else see him, right, an outsider see him doing it, he will think that this person in the grave has some type of hidden divine power. The other question, barakallahu fikum, that we left off was a very important issue also. هل لثبوت الردة شروط معتبرة, that do we have to establish that which is a ridda, conditions that are elucidating to it? And the Shaykh Hafidhahullah, he was mentioning in regard to this answer, barakallahu fikum, two things that will be, barakallahu fikum, the condition of establishing the ridda upon a person. Two conditions in this. Number one, that he is being excused. Bima'ana, he has udhra. He has an excuse for saying what he say of kufr, or for doing what he do of kufr. He is excused. Right? And we, inshallah ta'ala, as we develop into this, he is excused because of not knowing of what is the ruling on this issue that he is doing. So he did not know, mathalan. He is ba'id anil ilm. He is far away, removed from knowledge. There is no classes in his in his country. There is no scholar in his country. There is no no student knowledge in his country. So he say a word that is a word of kufr. Now before you rule out him to be a kafir, then you gotta make sure Allah yakunu ma'zuran bil jahl, that he is not to be somebody that could be excused for ignorance. Number one. That's why barakallahu feekum. Shuf, the Khawarij, they don't care about these things. Them, they will not make the difference between al-fi'l wal-fa'il. They don't make the difference between the action and the person is doing it. But in Islam, there is a difference. Fihi farq. Between the person doing an action and the action itself. The action itself, no doubt about it, is kufr. But now, how about the person doing it? How about the person doing it? Thaniyan, number two. Is that the person Adamu al-Ikrah? He is to be somebody that is not being forced. So number one, he's excused because of not being ignorant, of not being knowledgeable. And number two, if he is forced of doing something or saying something, you cannot blame him for that. Right? And as we all look into the hadith of Ammar ibn Yasir, three things Sheikh Saleh al-Fawzan mentioned. That it is a must to be there when a person is being compelled to do an action of kufr or to say an act of kufr, that even though he do it or say it, it will not be classified that he is a kafir. Three things must be in place. And we have mentioned it last week. His heart has to be firm upon iman. وَقَلْبُهُ مُطْمَئِنٌ بِالْإِيمَانِ Number two. Number two, very good. He is not saying it because he want to please the disbelievers. He is not saying what he's saying or doing what he's doing of kufr to please the disbelievers. Number three. And he is saying it to remove the harm that is being placed on him. Because they are torturing him. Right? It's a pain to be tortured. It's a heavy on him to be tortured. So he want to remove that harm from him. He want to remove their harm from him. That's why he, Ammar, he say what they wanted to him to say. And when he came to the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he told him clearly, after making sure what was the level state of his heart. After making sure what was the level state of his heart, he told him, if they repeat it, repeat it. If they go back again into doing the same thing, repeat the same words that you say, that way may wanted you to make you say. So these three things must be there. That the person is, while he is saying or he's doing the act or the statement of kufr, that his heart must be firm upon iman. Number two, that while he is saying or doing the act of kufr that they are making him do it, that he is doing it, barakallahu fikum, while he want to remove the harm that they're putting him into. And number three, that he is doing it not because he want to please the kuffar, but rather he is doing it but because he is being compelled of doing that action. Right? This is the three ones, barakah, in regard to that. The other question, barakallahu fikum, is the new dars, the new we started from here as al-qari. قال سائل يقول سائل
سؤال ما رأيكم في
ما
رأيكم في من يقول أن كتاب نوافذ الإسلام وكتاب
كشف الشبهات
كتاب كشف الشبهات تعلم الناس تكفير
التكفير نعم
وتجرهم على
ذلك.
فالأولى عدم
تدريسها.
عدم تدريسها للناس.
The questioner asked Sheikh Saleh al-Fawzan, ما رأيكم? What is your opinion? Feeman, in regard to those who say, yaqulu, that anna kitab nawaqid al-Islam, that the book of nawaqid al-Islam, and the other book, kashf al-shubuhat, right? It is teaching the people takfir. It is only teaching the people the issues of takfir. It is only teaching